गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस ऑन वन टॉपिक फ्रॉम इंडस्ट्रियल माइक्रोबायोलॉजी, दैट इज बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट्स ऑफ फर्मेंटेशन. व्हाट एवर द फर्मेंटेशंस आर देयर, दे आर बिकॉज ऑफ माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स. द माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स लाइक ईस्ट और बैक्टीरिया कन्वर्ट्स द कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स into some another chemical. Such procedure is generally referred as fermentation. This concept of fermentation is not new to the mankind. Since last 10,000 or 15,000 years, that is during Neolithic era, the fermentation process was known to the mankind. They were having certain observation, and on the basis of observation they were carrying out these processes, particularly with fruit juices. But that time they were not knowing that this is the process we can call it as a fermentation. Even traditionally there are different foods which we use are produced by this fermentation process. For example, the curd which we make, yogurt which we make, or whatever our alcoholic beverages are there, even the pickles we use in our food, bread, all these products are traditionally made by the industries as well as at our homes. All these products are made by fermentation process. This fermentation process today has become one of the important biological technology that can synthesize various valuable compounds to satisfy the requirement of our chemical industry, then our food needs, and even energy. This fermentation process usually is carried out on the organic substances, where microorganisms, with the help of their metabolic processes, bring about changes in the organic substances through enzymes produced by these microorganisms, and these chemical changes transform that organic substance into a very very valuable substance or chemical. During this process usually anaerobic condition is required by the microorganism. Human beings use this technology mainly for preservation of our foods. Particularly, you must have seen that whatever pickles which we make, these pickles are meant for preservation of our raw fruits, particularly mango. This raw mango is preserved by means of making pickles, and in this pickle production there is a role of microorganism and there is a fermentation process. Even the foodstuff which we make at our home, for example we make curd or yogurt or idli, these products are because of microorganisms only. And the beverages, particularly whatever the wines are there or beers are there, are made only because of microbial fermentation process. In this fermentation process, the word ferment which is used is derived from a Latin verb called as fervere. Now the fervere means to boil. This boiling action was observed by many observers, you can call them as a scientist, where they found that whatever fruit juices are there or malted grains are there, in that the yeast is to grow. And when that yeast grow, they start utilizing that sugars present in the fruit juice. And when they start utilizing that sugars present in the fruit juice, there is an production of CO2 gas. And this CO2 gas leads to bubbling in that juice. So from there, the ferment word and then the fermentation process has been derived. This yeast cells, when act on these fruit juices, particularly in anaerobic condition, they utilize sugars. Now why they utilize sugars? They utilize this sugar for obtaining energy, because energy is required for their growth as well as for their reproduction and for their metabolic activities. And when these sugars are utilized for energy production, during this energy production, there is a formation of ethyl alcohol and carbon dioxide. And that carbon dioxide which is produced leads to bubbling action in that fruit juice. Therefore, the concept of fermentation was established on the basis of these observations. Then there comes an issue of a definition, how to define this fermentation process. The term fermentation process can be defined in many ways. Today, we call any process where in aerobic or anaerobic condition, metabolic activities of microorganisms are carried out, in which some or specific chemical changes are brought about in an organic substance. And because of that, a new substance is formed which is important for the mankind. But after this, a new branch of microbiology was developed, which we call it as industrial microbiology. This is specifically deals with all these kinds of fermentations and the microorganism involved in fermentation process. In industrial microbiology point of view, the fermentation process has got a very, very broader definition. According to industrial microbiology, any process mediated by a microorganism or in which there is an involvement of the microorganism, whereby there is a product formation of economical value, then such process we can call it as a fermentation. Because the branch industrial microbiology which was developed, in which the fermentation processes which are dealt are mainly for economical benefit. So any process which may occur in aerobic or anaerobic condition, where the microorganism bring about chemical changes on organic substance and thereby produces a product of economical value is generally referred as a fermentation process. Today, there are many processes which can be called as fermentation processes, and they are carried out on a commercial basis. In this, a different types of products are produced by this fermentation process. Mainly, all these fermentation processes are classified or grouped into four groups. One, microbial biomass production, particularly the single cell protein. Nowadays, we are using proteins for food, and that time it is found that the microbial proteins are the cheapest source of protein. Therefore, on commercial scale, single cell protein is produced, and that is also done by fermentation process. For a bakery industry, there is a lot of demand for yeast cells, which are called as baker's yeast, and this baker's yeast is also produced on a commercial scale by a fermentation process. There is a second type or second group called as microbial enzymes. Now, in this microbial enzymes, there are certain enzymes which are used on a commercial basis by many industries. And in that, they require various types of enzymes like amylases, proteases, lipases, and all these enzymes which are required by these industries are produced with the help of microorganism by a fermentation process. Then there is a third group which we call it as microbial metabolites. Now in these microbial metabolites, there are two types, primary metabolites and secondary metabolite. Now what is this metabolite? Metabolite is a product of metabolism. In that, normally the metabolites which are there, we subgroup under primary metabolite and secondary metabolite, where usually the primary metabolites like amino acids, proteins, vitamins, polysaccharides, lipids, nucleotides are grouped. Now, why they are called as primary metabolites? Because during the growth of microorganism require certain substances, and these substances required by the microorganism during their growth are produced by these microorganism in their lag phase, logarithmic phase, or stationary phase. And all these substances, for their cell's own requirement, as they are produced by the microorganism, they are called as primary metabolites. Whereas there is a secondary metabolite. These are the substances produced by the microorganism during their growth, but they are not required by that microorganism for their own growth. Such substances are generally referred as secondary metabolites. Now, in these secondary metabolites, normally whatever the antimicrobial substances, today we call them as antibiotics, like penicillin, streptomycin, or different toxins are required, or certain anti-tumor agents are required, or certain miscellaneous compound, particularly different types of acids are there, like gibberellic acid, kojic acid is there. All these substances are produced by the microorganism during its metabolism, but they are not required by that microorganism. Therefore, they are known as secondary metabolites. Even there is a fourth subgroup, we call it as microbial transformation. Now, in this microbial transformation, there are certain substances. We call them as vinegar or steroids. Now, whatever these vinegar or steroids are there, these are the products of microbial transformation. What these microorganisms do is whatever one particular substance is there, that substance is converted by microbial enzymes into some structurally related compound, and when it is converted by the microbial enzymes into structurally related compound, the newly formed compound is of economical value, where a different enzymes play an important role, or different enzymes catalyze the reaction, like dehydrogenation, amination, deamination reaction, or even isomerization types of reaction. Because of that, this kind of transformation takes place. Even in some biochemical reactions, some biochemical transformation, there is only one biochemical reaction, only one enzyme play an important role and convert that substance into another substance, which is called as microbial fermentation. Now, keep in mind that whatever my fermentation processes are there, they are outcome of metabolic processes which are occurring during the growth of microorganism. And such metabolic reactions, when they carry out, whatever the substances which are produced, they are called as metabolites, and the process is called as metabolism. Now, what is this metabolism? Whatever this metabolism is there, it is derived from a Greek word called as metabolin. The meaning is to change. Now, this microbial metabolism, when it occurs inside the microorganism, it occurs only to derive energy and nutrients which are required by that microorganism to live and reproduce. So, whatever microbial metabolism which is occurring in any microorganism, it is mainly important for the growth and reproduction of that microorganism. Now, in this metabolism, if you want to define it, it is defined as sum of all chemical and physical processes which are continually occurring in the living microorganism and which are essential for life is generally referred as metabolism. Now, in this metabolism, two types of reactions usually takes place with the help of the various enzymes which are present or produced by the same microorganism. Usually, they produce or they carry out two types of reaction. One is called as catabolic reaction. The another is called as anabolic reaction, and the process of catabolic reaction is called as catabolism, and the process of anabolic reaction is called as anabolism. Now, what happens in the catabolism? Usually, whatever the food or nutrients which are taken by that microorganism, they are complex in nature. that cannot be directly used by that microorganism to derive energy. So therefore, what microorganism do is they utilize that complex nutrient with the help of the enzymes produced by themselves to convert it into simpler compounds. This process is called as catabolism. And once these simpler compounds are formed, by using that simpler compound, they again bring about a reactions in which they produce a different complex compound which is required for their own growth. For example, amino acids or proteins, they are derived from simpler compounds of catabolism, and this becomes a synthesis process. And this synthesis process, in which from simple compound two complex compounds are formed, then that is called as anabolism. Usually, whatever the catabolic reactions are there, all these are energy yielding reactions. Whereas whatever the anabolic reactions are there, all these anabolic reactions are known as biosynthetic reaction. Now, during this process of metabolism, there is a production of certain products, and all these products are the product of metabolism. Therefore, they are known as metabolites. Now, whatever these metabolites are there, all these metabolites are produced by the organism during its growth. Now, we graphically represent the growth into four stages: lag phase, logarithmic phase, and stationary phase, and death phase. Now, in that, these three phases are very, very important, which is known as lag, logarithmic, and stationary phase. Normally, all these primary metabolites which are there, they are produced during the growth, particularly in the lag phase, logarithmic phase, and stationary phase, because these are the substances which are required by the microorganism for their growth. Whereas the secondary metabolites are there, they are not required by the microorganism for their growth. Therefore, they are not produced during lag phase or logarithmic phase or during the beginning of stationary phase. It is usually found that during the end of stationary phase, many microorganisms produce certain substances which are not required by them, means they are not required for their growth. Such substances are known as secondary metabolites. And in this, there are different compounds, different chemical substances are produced by this microorganism, which are commercially important, and therefore they are produced on a commercial scale by a fermentation process. Certain examples of these primary metabolites, where there are certain anabolic metabolites where we produce enzymes, amino acids, vitamins, polysaccharides, citric acid, nucleic acid, and single cell protein. Whereas there are certain catabolic metabolites like ethanol or ethanol containing products, for example, wine, beer, butanol, acetic acid, lactic acid. So these are the examples of primary metabolites. Whereas in case of secondary metabolites, there are many substances we use in our life. For example, antibiotics. These are the medicines where the examples which are well known to us as penicillin, streptomycin, tetracycline, they are produced as a secondary metabolite by many bacteria and fungi. Even there are certain toxins which are required by these industries, like aflatoxin and amantine, they are example of secondary metabolites. Then there is alkaloid called as ergot's alkaloid, which is commercially important. It is a example of secondary metabolites. Even in today's medicinal practice, we require certain anti-tumor agents which are required for cancer treatment. For example, actinomycetes or bleomycin, they are produced by the microorganism as secondary metabolite. And there are certain miscellaneous compounds which are very much useful in our agricultural practices, like gibberellic acid or kojic acid is also an example of secondary metabolites, right? Now, out of these primary and secondary metabolites, usually it is found that microorganisms produce these primary metabolites in a large quantity and its extraction is comparatively easy, whereas the secondary metabolites are produced by the microorganism in a less quantity and its extraction is very, very difficult. So this is all about the basic concepts of fermentation. Thank you.